Hello viewers, welcome to AP's Ophthalmology Pearls. Today we shall discuss the laws of innervation. The two laws of innervation are Herring's law of equal innervation and Sherrington's law of reciprocal innervation. Herring's law states that during any conjugate eye movement, equal and simultaneous innervation flows to the yoke muscles. You may watch my video on yoke muscles from the link above or in the description box. Sherrington's law of reciprocal innervation states that increased innervation to a muscle is accompanied by a reciprocal decrease in innervation to its antagonist. You may watch my video on agonists and antagonists from the link above or in the description box. Sir Charles Sherrington shared the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1932 for his work on neuron function, synaptic communication, and reflexes. Let's see what these two laws mean. In dextroversion, equal and simultaneous innervation flows to the yoke muscles for dextroversion, that is the right lateral rectus and the left medial rectus. This is Herring's law. By Sherrington's law, there is a reciprocal inhibition of the right medial rectus, which is the antagonist of the right lateral rectus, and the left lateral rectus, which is the antagonist of the left medial rectus. This allows smooth movements. Similarly, in dextro elevation, equal and simultaneous innervation flows to the yoke muscles for dextro elevation, that is the right superior rectus and the left inferior oblique, according to Herring's law. While at the same time, according to Sherrington's law, there is an inhibitory signal to their respective antagonists, that is the right inferior rectus and the left superior oblique. Sherrington's law also applies to versions and vergences. For example, during convergence, while excitatory innervation is sent to both the medial recti, inhibitory messages are sent to both lateral recti. Now we shall see some of the applications of these two laws in clinical practice. Herring's law provides the scientific basis of the cover test. We shall study this with respect to a right lateral rectus palsy. In the primary position, because of weakness of the right lateral rectus, there is an unopposed action of the right medial rectus, which causes the right eye to adduct. So the patient presents with a right esotropia. This deviation of the affected eye in primary position with the normal eye fixing is referred to as the primary deviation. Now, when the right eye is forced to take up fixation by covering the normal left eye, since the right lateral rectus is weak, extra innervation has to flow to the right lateral rectus to make it abduct. By Herring's law, the same extra innervation also flows to the left medial rectus, which is the yoke muscle of the palsied right lateral rectus. This extra innervation causes the left medial rectus to overact, resulting in a deviation that is greater than the primary deviation. This is termed secondary deviation. So in a paralytic strabismus, the secondary deviation is greater than the primary deviation as a result of Herring's law. Let's see how these laws apply to a superior oblique palsy. Patients with a superior oblique palsy may fix with either eye. In a right superior oblique palsy with the normal left eye fixing, the primary deviation is a right hypertropia because of the unopposed action of its ipsilateral antagonist, the right inferior oblique. With the paritic eye fixing, extra innervation flows to the weak right superior oblique to enable it to fix. By Herring's law, this same extra innervation flows to its yoke muscle, the left inferior rectus, causing it to overact, along with an inhibition by Sherrington's law of its antagonist, the left superior rectus. The overaction of the left inferior rectus and underaction of the left superior rectus both result in a hypotropia of the left eye. In addition to this, when the paritic eye is fixing and moves into the field of action of the right inferior oblique, that is levo elevation, since the right inferior oblique is already contracted due to unopposed action, this muscle needs to contract very less in levo elevation, and so by Herring's law, this less innervation also flows to its yoke muscle, the left superior rectus. The left eye is thus hypotropic in levo elevation. This underaction of the left superior rectus by both these mechanisms is referred to as inhibitional palsy of the contralateral antagonist, as the left superior rectus is the contralateral antagonist of the right superior oblique, that is, it is the yoke muscle of the ipsilateral antagonist. Over time, due to anatomical changes in the right inferior oblique, there is further exaggeration of the inhibition of the contralateral antagonist. Herring's law of equal innervation has been hypothesized as a possible explanation for the dissociated contralateral horizontal gaze-evoked nystagmus in the abducting eye of an internuclear ophthalmoplegia. Increased innervation to the underacting adducting muscle would result in an enhanced stimulus to the contralateral abducting muscle. These laws are not universal and do have some exceptions, the important ones being dissociated vertical deviation, which is an exception to Herring's law, and Duane's retraction syndrome, which is an exception to Sherrington's law. Duane's because the lateral rectus co-contracts with the medial rectus instead of relaxing on adduction. So, to summarize, both these laws ensure smooth extraocular movements. Herring's law is the basis of the cover test. Herring's law explains the secondary deviation being greater than the primary deviation in a paralytic squint. The inhibitional palsy of the contralateral antagonist in a paralytic squint is a consequence of a complex interplay between Herring's and Sherrington's laws. And Herring's law has been advocated to be the cause of the abduction nystagmus in internuclear ophthalmoplegia. So that's it for today. If you like what you saw, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from AP's Ophthalmology Pulse. You might watch my other videos by clicking on the thumbnails. Please leave a note in the comment section if you wish for any particular topic to be covered in future. Look forward to regular updates. Thank you for watching.